Hi everyone, my name's Sany and welcome back to my maths adventure. Just before I begin this video, just want to give you a brief update on currently where I am. So as you know, I'm currently studying for my AS level maths test, which will be held next week. And this should be my final piece of work that my tutor will use to actually predict my grade. After the test, my predicted grade will be sent to the exam board for moderation. And A-level results day will be on Thursday the 13th of August, and the following week should be the GCSE results day. So I've got a long wait between next week and August, so it's going to be a really long summer, but that's how it is at the moment. If you haven't already, I really appreciate it if you can hit the like button. It will really mean a lot to me, and if you enjoy the content from me, hit the subscribe button for new weekly content. I should be uploading every Tuesdays now. So how did I start my GCSE maths journey? The journey really begins in 2016 when my employer decided that to apply for promotion, applicants needed an A to C in maths and English. So I had the English grades, but I didn't really have the maths grades because my grade was actually a D. Now this grade requirement isn't uncommon here in the UK. Most employers do require an A to C in maths and English. I just didn't think it would affect me so late in my career. So one day I thought, you know what, I'm gonna go back to college to study for my GCSE maths. So it was an easy decision for me because I wanted to advance in my professional career, and knowing that I was doing this would also put me in a better position to apply for future promotions. So before enrolling on the course, I knew it was gonna be difficult for me because I haven't studied maths in so many years since I left school. And also college only had one evening class a week for 3 hours, and that was it. So you're not gonna get a lot of contact time with the tutor. It's really gonna be just about the teacher in front of a board writing everything out, and you having to actually take all that material. If you didn't understand anything in class, then perhaps I knew I would have to have a lot of independent study and also homework to understand concepts that were difficult for me in class. I then started evening studies and remember everything going great for the first couple of months, and then something strange happened. I started enjoying maths and started becoming really good at it. In fact, I don't remember if it was enjoying maths first and being good at it, or being good at it and enjoying maths. It's one of those two, but it doesn't matter. I really started to enjoy what I was doing. Anyway, as time progressed, this confluence of enjoying mathematics and being good at mathematics really changed my perspective in terms of like my career and how I actually saw my math studies. No longer was it a way to actually gain promotion at work in my professional career, but it was something that I could continue and pursue and take further. And that was the mindset that really changed everything, the realization that I could go further with my maths studies. I didn't have to really stop at A level. I could go to do a degree. I could go to do a master's if I wanted to, perhaps a PhD. At that moment in time, I knew the world was limitless in terms of what I wanted to achieve with my maths qualification. I just had to work hard for it and get a good grade. So the months passed and I became even better at my maths. There wasn't really anything that I could do if I didn't put my mind to it. I started to help other students with their homework and any sort of subjects they were finding very difficult. For me, explaining things to my classmates really enhanced my knowledge and skill set as well, because I really had to find simple ways to actually explain complicated subjects and concepts to my fellow classmates who didn't really understand it to a certain level. So that really enhanced my sort of teaching and understanding capability. Then the months passed. I remember I started the GCSE course in 2016. Christmas passed, and then we got into 2017, into spring, and then really the end of the course and the start of the exam season. Luckily, as I said in my last video, I had, and still do, have a really understanding employer. I got plenty of time off for revision and for my exams. So the GCSE maths exams consisted of two papers. The first one was a non-calculator one. The following week was the calculator paper. I remember that I did relatively well. I knew I did enough to get a good grade, I just knew. Don't get me wrong, there were questions I absolutely flunked or didn't attempt, but I think I did enough. It wasn't a complete victory, but it was a victory for the best grade that I thought I could achieve. So that was in May 2016. Then I had to wait for the months past, the long wait for results day in August. I decided to go to college to actually collect my exam results rather than having them sent to me. I remember when I walked into college, there was my teacher. She came kind of like gave me this wry smile, which kind of like gave away what potentially my grade would be. So at that point, I just knew that it would be an A grade or potentially an A star. Which one, I didn't really know. I looked at the board and remember I saw it was an A star. I remember seeing the grade and remembering this huge weight being lifted off my shoulders. The relief knowing that it was finally over. I remember seeing my tutor for the last time. I gave her a big hug and said thank you. She said congratulations and she reminded me that I mustn't stop here and try and take my mathematics studies further if I can, because I had potential to do really, really well. So here's my maths certificate, which I got in 2017. It's just to say that I obtained one result shown in the following subject in mathematics, linear, A style. So this is the first of many certificates, I hope. One tip I would give to mature students if you're doing an evening course is to treat that course as an extension of your full-time job. So you've got to keep on point with your timekeeping as you do at work, hopefully. So get to school on time, put your mobile phones away, pay attention in class. If your manager at work gives you an assignment to do or a report to do, that's similar at college to your tutor giving you homework. So make sure you do it to the best as you can and also hand it in on time. For me personally, I never saw a distinction between my full-time job and my evening studies. They were essentially the same to me. My studies was just an extension of my job, and perhaps you should treat it like that as well. And that's my journey so far. Bit of a long story, but we got there in the end and we're up to date. Next week, I'll post my first study with me video. Hopefully I can get that done for 30 minutes. So join me next week for some gentle calculus studies. Remember to click the subscribe button to get a reminder when that video is up and hit the like button if you really enjoyed this video. So thank you again and I'll see you in the next video.